I think our goal should be trying to make as large of a percentage of people live a reasonably happy life as much as possible. In this country, white people are in the majority, and white culture is the majority culture. Most things are going to be marketed first to white people as a result, and I think a lot of people nowadays realize this. But then some get upset when those who are not white talk about not being able to find products marketed for them very easily. And I have to ask, why does that make you upset that they're talking about that? I mean, is it because you can't say, well, all humans are humans, as the answer? Or because you don't want to think about it because those are first world problems, while you complain about your latest console game and how it doesn't have the improved engine you'd hoped for, and your smartphone doesn't have the options you wanted? What drives me nuts is that people have no problem with companies breaking people apart via their demographics for marketing purposes, and we can talk left and right about demographics when it comes to businesses, and we can hate certain demographics, but if we talk about demographics to facilitate trying to get the best help to those who seem to need it the most in an efficient manner, it's somehow evil, and suddenly you'll now state aloud in an angry voice that all humans are humans. Because you're angry. But then other times you argue against the idea that all humans are humans when someone shows up who fits a certain demographic, like, oh, I don't know, maybe a Muslim. And that person who is now known to be a Muslim is now just ever so teeny tiny little bitty slightly less of a human than most other humans as a result of knowing this about them. The same with someone who's in a gang, or someone who committed a lot of crimes in their teenage years and early 20s, did their time, and in their 30s came out a better person for wanting to improve their lives. Because according to the weird mindset that's very popular on this platform, it's considered totally fine to actually use someone's demographic as a judgment against them, but unacceptable to use someone else's demographic to try to get them help more efficiently based on the needs of what is normally thought of for that demographic. When we talk about helping people, the argument is that humans are humans and talking about demographics and acting on demographics is bad, very bad. When we talk about hurting people or disliking people, the argument is that some humans are worth more than other humans and that talking about demographics are good because Muslims are bad and if we treat them like other humans, Sharia will take over and we'll all be beating and raping women and throwing gays off buildings. And so a lot of people who fit the majority demographic in this country feel threatened by the idea that at some point in the future, they may not be the default, they may not be in the majority anymore, and any attempts to get us prepared for that upcoming reality is met with anger. Some people may ask why it has to be that way, why the majority demographic isn't going to be in the majority in the future, and the answer is that's just the progression that is carrying out, and the only way to do something about it is to push forth some sort of racial-based nationalism, and in white majority countries, that would be white nationalism. Oh no, I said the words white nationalism. That must mean I'm anti-white or something like that because I didn't also talk about black nationalism, which exists, obviously, but I'm anti-white because anti-racism is anti-white and Bob's mantra and all that shit that 6 years ago everyone made fun of for being the drivel that it is. People really, truly don't want to give up that feeling like we're the most important people in this country because we're in the majority and don't want to think about the future, and we don't want to think about how to make things better for those who aren't in the majority. People are grasping with their hands onto that feeling tight enough to have bloody hands. We're the most important. Don't take that away from us because we're in the majority. You can't make us think otherwise. We don't want to think about what other demographics go through because all humans are humans. All people are people, so shut up. Be quiet, you stupid, poopy-head, diaper-pants, regressive pussy. And so if people merely talk about what they go through as a different demographic than the majority, people get all pissy about it and yet again very selectively say that all humans are humans, all people are people, and that there's no such thing as problems that one demographic goes through that are any different than problems that other demographics go through. Let's ignore all of those differences because they don't actually exist, no matter how much proof there is of otherwise. Just like the same crowd says there's no such thing as online bullying, and they essentially state over and over again that all humans are humans, all people are people, and all problems are problems. Say it with me now. All humans are humans, all people are people, and all problems are problems. Very good. Let me give you a sucker now. What flavor do you want? But then in other contexts, the same people will be willing to put down those demographics for not coming to our demographic standards, even though we don't come to their standards either. But we're in the majority. They need to come to our standards. We shouldn't have to think about what other standards are because we're number one. USA! USA! And yes, we need to promote that people follow the laws we have, and that people don't get to live outside the law, of course. That should go without saying. Nobody should get to use their religion to get around having to follow the laws. So it basically becomes an argument of talking about demographics is bad. Talking about demographics is good. No, they're bad. No, they're good. But they're bad, but good. Good. Bad, bad, good. Stop making me flip-flop. Your stupid progressive ideals made me do it. You're the reason I can't be consistent on my position. Wait, this sort of thing is always said in an angry masculine voice, so it should be, stop making me flip-flop. Your stupid progressive ideals made me do it. You're the reason I can't be consistent on my position. You stupid, pathetic, regressive pussy retard. Go kill yourself. And the thing is, if you talk at all, negatively, in any way, about things about the majority demographic, and you happen to be black, then you're racist against white people. And if you're white and talk about it, well, that means you hate yourself, you're pushing white guilt, and that you're a regressive pussy who needs to grow some balls and stop drinking the Kool-Aid. After all, using this logic, there's nothing wrong with the gay community, so I guess I should just shut up about any issues I see in my own gay community, or I'm actually a self-loathing gay person. After all, there's nothing wrong with the black community, so black people should just shut up about any problems they see in their own communities either. Oh, those things are fine to talk about? Oh, okay. So how about those problems in the white community? Oh, that's still bad and makes me anti-white to talk about. And all lives matter and all people are people and... okay. So if I call you a racist for saying that the reason why so many police profile all black people as being criminals and treat them as criminals is because statistically black people commit more crimes, then I'm slandering you and ruining your reputation because I use the word racist in association with you, because you're not really a racist, you just have racist views and blame all the problems associated with that race on that race itself and not the circumstances the people of that race tend to be under. But you're not really racist because that's slander to say otherwise, and all people are people, and all humans are humans, you know. Only regressive pussies who want the government to tell people what food they can eat on what days, and who they should date, and what kind of car they can drive, would call someone racist for saying racist things. I mean, come on! How regressive and totalitarian do you have to be to actually think that racism is racism? I mean, that's crazy talk. Talk to the hand, because anti-racist is a code word for anti-white. Marmite Man 4, the BNP, and UKIP told me so because Barbara Spector said that Europe is going to go into multicultural mode and therefore wants white people to be exterminated via population changes because that's actually white genocide, because things and stuff, and you're a regressive pussy, and the Jews are bad. It's the Jews, and Muslims, and black people who are tired of being treated like crap by police, because love is hate, and hate is love. Being compliant is actually resisting arrests. Putting your hands in the air doesn't mean anything because you didn't step forward exactly when the officer told you after they busted your door open because earlier you ran a stop sign. And they sprayed pepper spray in the face of a crippled up old black woman in her 80s. Oops, I shouldn't have said her race because all lives matter because the Jews and white genocide and there's a conspiracy to take away your guns. Because feminism hates white people. They're the reason why Jews want police to spray old black ladies in the face with pepper spray, and the reason why Muslims rape women in first world countries. Because Muslims are bad, even the ones that are good. Because love is hate, and hate is a four-letter word that only regressive pussies say to hateful people. Because after all, she didn't comply. She didn't comply. Stupid, crippled up old lady. She didn't comply. Pepper spray her and throw her to the ground, stupid old black lady. Don't you know that black people commit more crimes and it would be slander or libel for me to claim that it's a racist thing to say even in this context? Because I'm a regressive pussy, because I believe in love, I believe in acceptance, I believe in pacifism until a different position is absolutely necessary, I believe in tolerance, I believe that we should help as many people as we can in as efficient and helpful ways as we can, and because of that, I guess I hate white people, because the Jews and I'm a cuck, and 666 and the Illuminati and used tampons fried in bleach, because white genocide is real and Bob's mantra says the truth about used toilet paper, we're staining it brown and flushing whiteness down the toilet because we're anti-white in a regressive flushing sort of motion. Because talking about this stuff feels pee-pee-ish. So stop putting my fingers in warm water when I'm sleeping. Thanks.